you see that the whole way that we define law becomes very different. Law is not anymore what is just in the books or in the texts. And there has been a nice definition that Pierre Legendre was like a historian of law in France. So he's talking about Western law, but his definition was quite nice. So in a Western context, law is the dogmatic art of knotting together the biological, the social, and the unconscious for the reproduction of humanity. So you can put another one here if you want. Biological, the unconscious, and the social for the reproduction of humanity. So what we have done here, we have reached, let me say a few words on it now and we'll finish there. We have reached law. After having explored the question of pluralism, this we have started in the context of globalization. We're scientists, no? So we started with the basic question of science. And here of communication, huh? How do we communicate? And so now to finish, I promised a third movement, so this will be a 2 minutes movement. So daring to enter the pluriverse. See, one of the big problems is that law has been thought of in a very unitarian way. And there was one very important article by Jacques Griffiths, which was called "What is Legal Pluralism?" And in this article, he makes a distinction between legal centralism and legal pluralism. And he says legal centralism is this idea that law is only what the state is saying and what the official law is, basically. And he says this is an ideology. It's not truth, you know, it's a prescriptive way of looking at reality. But in the real context, in the colonial context, we saw that there's other things happening. So he says the reality is legal pluralism. And this reality can either be a weak legal pluralism, in the sense that it's also recognized by the state. You can have your personal laws in that and that domain. Or it can be a strong legal pluralism, because life goes beyond what only like any state or law may say. So the big challenges in law, and more generally like in political science and so on, is to leave this idea from a universe to go to a pluriverse. And to do what De Sousa Santos, Boaventura de Sousa Santos, it's a very interesting person to read. He wrote a book which is called Tower, A New Common Sense. It was like 1995. Law, Science and Politics in the Paradigmatic Transition. And he has one nice chapter, I like that chapter. It was called Don't Shoot the Utopist. And in that chapter he says, okay, it's nice to deconstruct. We like to do that, you know, postmodern theories, we deconstruct, deconstruct, deconstruct. But what do we reconstruct? It's nice to deconstruct, but what new do we want to make? And so there he says, maybe we need a new utopia. You know, we need some new idea. But instead to have a utopia which is an atopia, like a place which does not exist, except in our imagination, maybe we have to move to a heterotopia. And from this he means we have to change our point of view from the center to the margins. Like if you talk in terms of power. In terms of just trying to see things from the center of power, we have already all the answers, we move to the margins. And then a very, very different picture may appear. We move from my law I learned at the beginning to what are all these people doing? What, like the 80%, for example, in India would not live by the modern law. Do they not have anything? Is what they're doing nonsense? Are they just some remnants of some past, you know, which should not really be here and as soon as possible be replaced by like a modern version of themselves? Or is there maybe some richness there? And so Robert Vachon, one of my big influences, was the director of the Intercultural Institute of Montreal, like a research director. He liked to say very much, the other is not a void to be filled. It's a plenitude to be discovered. So, oh, he doesn't have this, he doesn't have that, he doesn't, we have to bring in democracy and human rights in development. No, he can also tell, oh, you don't have this and this and this and this and this. So try to see the plenitude which is there. And so what I said at the beginning, the context nowadays, the positive side of governance, good governance, participation, sustainable development, is that it in a certain way opens up the door to more holistic and more interdisciplinary approaches. At the beginning you did this kind of lean anthropology, people would just say, oh, that's interesting, but it's not law, so we don't talk about it. But yeah, okay, that's sociology, good, nice, but so what? And in the moment you start to talk in terms especially of participation, responsibility of the actors, and all these kind of things, well then, this becomes audible. The audience can start to hear what you're trying to say. And so there may be hope to start living our lives. So that is like the one sentence I like to say very much, which is inspired by Robert Vachon, that our life is not a void to be filled. It's also a plenitude to be discovered. And so I hope that here in a more scientific context, I have shown like one way of discovering some of these plenitudes which is there. But I also really on the personal level, I just wish, you know, it's wonderful to be a student and a scientist, and I've been there also, and it's a beautiful thing. But don't forget to live and to enjoy the beauty of life also. And you can learn so many things, sometimes from people you would not expect. Somebody you may meet in some park or outside, there's lots of wisdom which is not only the wisdom that is there in books and big institutions. So thank you very much for your listening. And so we still have, I think, can we have like 10, 15 minutes or 20 minutes? I'm there. If some of you really have to leave, you can leave. Otherwise, you just tell me when we have to officially close and...